talk about this blockchain, this Bitcoin. Now, where do we store these cryptocurrencies? Where can we store them? Can keep them in something called wallet, okay? Cryptocurrency wallet. It's a tool used to interact with the blockchain network, and they can be divided into three main categories. We have the software wallets, web wallets, and then desktop wallet, mobile wallets, hardware wallet, also have paper wallets, okay? So, now, depending on their working mechanism, okay, depending on the tool they are on, be it mobile, PC, paper wallets, or hardware, okay, they may refer to as hot or cold wallet. A hot wallet is any wallet that is connected somehow to the internet. Okay, long as it's connected to the internet, it's known as a hot wallet. Okay. For example, when you create an account on Binance and you send funds to your wallet, you are depositing into Binance hot wallet. These wallets are quite easy to set up and the funds are quickly accessible, making them convenient for traders and other users. Okay. So, but then on the other hand, a cold wallet is a wallet that has no internet connection. Instead, they use a physical medium to store their keys offline, making them resistant to online hacking attempts. This method is also known as cold storage and is particularly suitable for long-term investors. Let's say you just want to buy and keep Bitcoin, you can just get a cold wallet or an offline wallet, buy your Bitcoin, keep, okay? Or a cold wallet. Examples of these cold wallets are, you know, all those Trezor, Ledger Nano, and the rest. Those offline wallets, okay? So now, software wallet come in many different types, each with its own unique characteristics. Most of them are all connected to the internet, okay? So they are connected to hot wallets. While hardware wallets are physical devices, electronic devices that use random number generator to generate public and private keys, and the keys are stored in the device itself, okay, which isn't connected to the internet. Hardware storage constitutes the type of cold wallet and is deemed as one of the most secure alternatives. So, a paper wallet is a piece of a paper which crypto address and its private key are physically printed out to form QR code. And it's risky due to numerous flows. For example, they aren't suitable for sending funds personally, because it's only entire balance. You can only send the entire balance as well, okay? A lot of people lost money on that. Paper wallet is not really that in use like that, okay? So let me show you example of a hardware wallet. Let me show you Trezor. Kevin, if you on that journey from So let me show you example of a hardware wallet. This is Trezor. All right, this is Trezor. This is example of a Trezor wallet. This is hardware wallet. Mm-hmm. If you are following me on my status, you know I do sell some of these stuff. Okay, I do post them on my timeline once a while. Okay, this is Trezor. And we have Ledger Nano as well. Ledger Nano. Okay, we have Ledger Nano X and the rest of them. We have so many other hardware wallet, but these are the two most popular ones. Okay, this is a Ledger Nano X, so and so on and so forth.